Welcome to Fantastic Vision. Please subscribe us before you watch today's video. As we all know, chips are crucial to the development of a country's science and technology. As the birthplace of semiconductor chips, the United States has made transistors and integrated circuits decades ago, and has taken the lead in acquiring many chip technologies. Precisely because the United States is the dominant player in the field of semiconductor chips and all aspects of the global industrial chain are affected by them, the United States basically has the final say in the chip field. Even current chip giants such as TSMC and Samsung have to look at it. America acts with a face. Seeing that the containment has failed, the United States will intensify its efforts and directly require countries such as Japan and the Netherlands to issue and implement the so-called tripartite agreement. As a follower of the United States, Japan took the lead in disclosing the specific details of the tripartite agreement, including cutting off the supply of 23 important semiconductor equipment materials and requiring China's core manufacturing process to return to 45 nanometers. The Netherlands has its own ideas about the tripartite agreement. On the one hand, it said it would control the export of high-end DUV lithography machines. On the other hand, relevant politicians submitted their resignations. It is obvious that they do not want to be caught between the United States and China and become the backing of the United States. The reason why the Netherlands is like this is because they have seen the rapid development of China's semiconductor chips and major technological fields in recent years. ASML Wenkening bluntly said that the containment of the United States will only lead to the acceleration of China's technological development, and this is indeed the case. ASML once said that they firmly oppose the United States' expansion of shipment restrictions on DUV lithography machines. Because this is a mature technology, and they have already compromised on the shipment of EUV lithography equipment to the United States. The implication is that the United States should not kill all the mainland market and ASML shipments. However, ASML's opposition was ineffective. The scope of shipment restrictions for DUV lithography equipment was still expanded, and ASML, which was deeply influenced by American technology, had to compromise again. But the situation seems to be increasingly out of the control of the United States. After the reappearance of Huawei's Korean chips, many parties in the United States began to speak out urgently. In this environment, ASML seems to have found a breakthrough that allows the United States to relax restrictions. According to its executives, the current emergence of Huawei's chips means that U.S. restrictions are ineffective, and decoupling from Chinese semiconductors will only make the situation more and more passive. Therefore, they said they should share technology with China to help China's semiconductor innovation. EUV lithography machines are restricted, and some models of DUV lithography machines are restricted. ASML's move is to speak out for EUV lithography machines, sell EUV lithography machines to China, and further achieve ASML's talk about sharing technology with China. In this regard, US media believe that ASML's move to break the blockade and ship EUV lithography machines is feasible because the United States is currently experiencing internal strife. Regarding the fact that Huawei chips are manufactured by Chinese chip manufacturers, there are two voices in the United States. Part of them hopes that the United States will further tighten restrictions, such as examining which companies have shipped illegally to Huawei, and then suppress Huawei's chips again. Others believe that if the suppression continues, more US companies will lose market interests, and the semiconductor industry needs the huge Chinese market. Obviously, the US media's understanding is correct. Internal strife has begun in the United States. Under this situation, if ASML and other related companies speak out, they may be able to win the relaxation of restrictions. Therefore, they believe that ASML chose to make remarks such as sharing technology at this critical moment because it was based on the current trend and has a certain probability of success. However, I personally believe that ASML may not be able to open up a breakthrough in shipping EUV lithography machines in a situation where the United States is in opposition to restrictive measures. First of all, for a long time in the past, there have actually been different voices within the United States. One side wants to sell chips to customers in the mainland market, while the other side wants to continue to tighten restrictions. Not only does it not sell chips, not selling equipment will limit enterprises' investment in mainland China. With different voices, the results are also very clear. The United States has been tightening its restrictions step by step, and has not changed the original intention of their restrictions because of such disputes. In the final analysis, the United States does not simply want to suppress the development of mainland semiconductors, but in suppressing the development of mainland semiconductors, it will make life difficult for its partners in the so-called chip alliance. Only in this way can they truly maintain their advantage in US technological hegemony. Therefore, ASML, as an ally, is unlikely to listen to ASML's voice and bring semiconductor advantages to the Netherlands. Secondly, the United States has always emphasized the importance of technological security being in their own hands, and the hype about the inability to ship products is all about de-risking. At this point, the mainland has repeatedly asked them to give an explanation and has repeatedly opposed their illegal, restrictive actions. But they would rather try to convince China that they are de-risking than really open a hole for technological exports. This shows that de-risking is their foundation. Under this fundamental factor, it is very likely that they will not take the so-called shared technology path. Although, taking this path will allow their US companies to gain more benefits, and the technological cooperation between the two parties will be taken to a higher level. Generally speaking, I personally don't think the probability of EUV lithography machines being shipped is very high. Even if the United States intends to relax, at most it will relax restrictions on DUV lithography machines. What do you think about this? Welcome to leave comments, like and share this.